Ulrich Robert, known as Namasan, born in Ekurhuleni. I grew up in Cape Town, Western Province, stayed in Macassar, and where I did my schooling. As a young student, I draw a lot. My parents, they saw my talent, and I think from there, my background as an artist started in Macassar. Back to Namakwa, a good couple of years ago, to really retrace my roots and where I made my art industry, my studio. From all over the world, I would also see myself as a citizen of the world. Nama, most definitely, of the root of the area and the landscape. So that is my background, I suppose. I think for me, storytelling is what is important. In my art, I tell stories. I look at society, I look at my own background, landscape. I tell the story of Namakwa, I tell the story of struggle. Specifically, one of my exhibition pieces called The Origin of Wisdom, talking much about indigenous knowledge of the come and memories that should be kept sacred. My inspiration flows from a multitude of things. The nature by itself is my inspiration. Also protecting the land, protecting the environment, that's very crucial in our times. My Nama culture and also my eclectic world culture. I started very young with oil paint and fell in love with the permanency of the medium, the texture, the smell. I work also with a technique called pointillism, so mark making with a dot. I would like to think about my art as a living memory, something that will be valuable in 100 and 200 years from now, even beyond. The language of our time is what I try to capture through use of color, use of subject. And as an artist, it is our duty, I feel, to challenge our communities and our society, to take lead in thought processes and also to change thought processes. And I also take on harsh stories, deep-rooted tragedies that I try to look into and try to find a visual portrayal of a story. And that's how I try to let the painting paint itself in a way. We have to look after the planet, otherwise the planet will not look after us. And I do try, as a humble artist, to be able to tell society's story and to make a change. And so on, I've been privileged working alongside many great South African artists. They have all brought a little bit of inspiration. I've definitely, as a student, studied some of the European and African contexts, and I play the world instrument known as the didgeridoo, birthplace Australia. But this instrument has also changed the way I look to myself as an artist. My art gives me joy. It also gives me the opportunity to reflect, a challenge. In life, to be able to work as an artist, to survive as an artist, to be able to feed a family, to be able to also tell my story and share my life through my art. And people that buy my art also share a part of my life. Doing art is to be able to deep into pain, to deep into what society needs. My rhythm in my art is to be able to see my golden thread always in my highs and in my lows as a life continuum. There's so much to learn, and as an artist, there's no ceiling in learning. To be able to be born again, to be resilient, to never give up, to be as stable as this continent, and also as its people, to have that kind of inspiration. It's a blessing to live in Africa.